Are we really taking security screening seriously? I'm Brian Lilly with the Rebel.media. Look, I'm happy to see that the Liberal government under Justin Trudeau has agreed to back away from their crazy plan to bring 25,000 Syrian refugees to Canada in a month. And this is the really scary part. They wanted to do this by having the security screening done in Canada after people arrived. That was part of the plan laid out by Immigration Minister John McCallum and so many others in interviews, media appearances. They wanted Canadians to believe there was no problem with that. I truly think it's a victory for common sense and sanity that the government is slowing down and also now committing to doing the security screening overseas.
So before anyone gets on a plane to come to Canada, the security screening will be completed, fully completed, overseas. If there is any doubt about an application or an interview or any of the data, the file will simply be put aside and held for further consideration at a later time.
Now, why is that important? Because if we brought people to Canada first and then found out that, hey, in addition to real refugees, we'd scooped up terrorists or war criminals, some ISIS fighters, guess what? We wouldn't be able to get rid of them. Charter protections and appeal, well, they would kick in. It took us from 1988 to 2013 to get rid of one convicted terrorist that snuck into Canada. We've been trying to kick out another since 2000, and a court ruling last week ordering him out. It's not the end of his road. So we really need to get this right. But despite the slowdown, despite the screening being done overseas, I'm not sure we've got it right yet. Are we going to be screening not only for known terrorists and war criminals, but also screening based on worldviews, the goals and tactics of ISIS? Will we screen people that, or screen out people that agree with those? Yes, I'm talking about screening for ideology. And that's an idea that will not sit well with some people. But when we're importing a medium-sized Canadian city into this country, not only from another country and another culture, but from one of the most violent places on the planet right now, where some people believe that honor killings, killing a woman because she was raped, is okay. People that believe it's appropriate to throw gays and lesbians off tall buildings. I think, well, call me a bigot, call me crazy, but I don't want people that believe in that to come here. So are we going to screen on those issues? I hope to ask Public Safety Minister Ralph Goodale that question during his news conference the other day, but after long opening statements, Goodale and the other ministers didn't leave a lot of time for questions. They didn't even take questions from half the journalists that put their names forward. So I put in a request to Goodale's office. I'd like to minister on camera, or I'd like a response to my questions. And I specifically said, will the government be vetting for ideology? And I said, we have seen polls of several Middle Eastern countries that show negative attitudes towards Israel, the United States, gays, lesbians, minority groups, and support for ISIS. I linked to the poll from the Doha Institute showing that 31% of those living in the Syrian refugee camps opposed the idea of the U.S. coalition degrading ISIS. It also showed 13% support in the camps for ISIS. That's outright support. So are we going to screen those people out? It's a serious question. I mean, we're now being ruled by people that never stop telling us how much they love the Charter of Rights and Freedoms. Well, where does it say? Where does it say in the Charter of Rights and Freedoms, throw gays off tall buildings to their deaths, kill Christians that won't submit, or have an honor killing if a woman in your family is raped through no fault of her own? I don't know about you, but I haven't seen that in the Charter. And yet, some of those views, well, those are the views of some of the people that could be coming. That's the views of some of the people in the camp. Not all, but some. Another recent poll found 22% support ISIS. So it was against this backdrop that I asked Goodale's office for comment. Their response? Send me his talking points, a text of what Goodale had said about collecting biometric data the day before, followed by this gem. Throughout our history, the immigrants and refugees that have come to Canada have enriched our country, and we want to offer these newest arrivals the means to integrate successfully into our society. With counseling, cultural orientation, and other services, they will receive assistance to adapt to Canadian society as quickly as possible. None of that answers my questions. And look, I want these people to adapt as quickly as possible to Canadian society. I want it to be successful because it's better for all of us. They're coming one way or another. We want it to be successful. But don't you think screening for ideology might be in order? Goodale didn't answer that question. He didn't touch on it. But we're going to keep answering until they give us an acceptable answer.